Church and the District Gazette. It is at last the right time to
sit. Am I late?
Everything's ready but you.
Sorry, Miss Pike. Punctured my bike.
Punctured your bike. Punctured your bike. For 3 precious weeks we've been calling and screaming, bustling and bumping, hurrying and serving. Surely you know that the medicine is invincible. Late this on May Day's quite indefensible. Mr. Dippers, I must fly, or they'll leave me out.
You bundle up, that'll be much more sensible. That's a fine sight for sore eyes.
Don't you think it's a splendid surprise?
And they make all this fuss, cause Albert's too shy to go out on a bust.
What was it like down there in the town?
Churchyard's agog with a crowd of folk who couldn't get in for the service. Seats have been kept for the band of Hawk, and each choir boy has got a new surplice. The vicar is preaching on living chaste for the hereafter. Some of his listeners are solemn-faced. Some near to laughter. And Albert, sitting there in his pew, the poor kid looks on tenterhooks. He's in the mood to escape if he could. I'd like to see him go for good.
Sid, tell me the truth about why you were late.
What do you mean?
You've got some skin.
How did you guess?
I know, by the grin on your face and the gleam in your eye. Confess.
Can you keep a secret?
Mum, as a wisdom.
Then I'll tell you the plot while we empty this box.
One and two.
spaceship, ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, I shall not trespass on your time. I rise ex officio to introduce her ladyship and ask her if she will consent to make a little speech before we take our fare.
Thank you, Mr. Gedge.
In which he'll find £5.
Fascinating, Mr. Mayor. A fitting gift indeed to store away for a rainy day and keep in case of need. And now, Miss Wordsworth, you will not disappoint us.
Oh,
I see you have a surprise. I see. Book of Martyrs, three cornerstones of our national heritage. Thank you, Miss Wordsworth, very much. To make our thanks complete, one voice is missing. Yes, Mr. Bond, last but hardly.
There's a speech of fire, but my heart's warm enough, if you know what I mean. It's chaps like young Albert keep the British Empire on top of the world, where it has always been. Good old Albert, good old Albert, that's my opinion. Forget to thank Mrs. Williams for the love of a flagpole and 24 cups.
Thank you, thank you. Now, I'm certain Albert feels the need of speaking in his turn, returning thanks for gifts received before the feast begun.
Don't be scared.
Oh, Albert!
Come along now!
thank you very much.
More. your little Albert, your sugar plum, or the prodigal son. Clean as a whistle, sound as a drum, from his coronation. She's gone to call on Aunt Em for a cup of tea and a chat. Left me coming straight home to bed, but I'm blown if I'm ready for that. I'm blown if I'm ready for that. Doc and he must find a match.
Pretty name, Nancy.
fancy. No, she belongs to Sid, not me. We never talked or walked lightheartedly through the wood, nor shall that I can see. Girls don't care for chaps like me. I'm too shy to reply entertainingly when they speak. I lose my nerve and fly. Lose my nerve and fly. Sounds like Sid serenading under her window, impatient at waiting, impatiently aching to take Nancy chasing love and adventure. He wants by directness, simplicity, aims at his target with shameless audacity, trades on the fact of his ruthless tenacity.
Open to whistle, I told you that's it.
It's perishing cold standing here in the street. 25 minutes, I'm frozen stiff.
I came down the stairs as quick as I could.
Let's call at the pub for a couple of pours.
Certainly mustn't.
Warm us up quick.
No, people will talk.
They've enough food for Chatter and Albert tonight, so us two won't matter.
Poor kid, it does seem wrong to show him off to everyone like a sort of plaster saint for the village simpleton.
Oh, he's all right. Once he's sown a few wild oats, he'll live that down.
But how can he sow them?
Share providing the rum. Are you volunteering to cheer him along the agreeable primrose path?
Of course not. Still, I'd like to help.
Heaven helps those who help themselves.
It's getting terrible chilly. It'll be terrible cold up there on the common.
You needn't be frightened with me. Come along, darling, come follow me quick. Time is racing fast around the clock, ticking and talking our evening away, which we hoped for and longed for.
Hurry to play. Youth must hurry at headlong pace. Squeezing and squeezing the pleasures of love.
Be the cheerful.
Thank you. shan't need rocking myself.